Welcome back. My name is Karanja Alex. You're watching What 254, and as always, this is Tuesday, and we usually do entrepreneurship. Today, I'm joined by two great men. Today, a lot of ladies. Today, I'm joined by two great men, and of course, I want to bring them on board. One is called Martin Irungu. He's the co-founder and executive director of MSAP. Karibu sana.
Thank you so much.
It's great to have you here.
Thank you.
We'll be talking, of course, later on. Also, we have Derek Gakuo, who is the GES. That is the grassroots, yeah? All right, who is the communication lead in terms of technology?
Yeah, and in terms of communication technology,
All right. So, sawa, karibuni sana.
Asante sana.
It's nice to have you here.
Thank you.
You have been here again?
Yes, yeah. We were here last year at a time like this. We were also discussing the same agenda on the Grassroots Entrepreneurship Summit, which we did last year. It's an amazing thing.
So, we here talk about the Grassroots Summit. It's about entrepreneurship and growing the women. So, let's begin this. How do you think the field is for women right now?
I would say like the conversation around women and social entrepreneurship, it's a growing conversation. We have the ecosystem ready to support upcoming women in entrepreneurship. And I think that's where our organization comes in handy. And that's why this year when we were organizing for Entrepreneurship Summit, we themed it around women, and specific theme is demystify the place of women social entrepreneurship in the ecosystem. And I think it's a growing trend. They have an opportunity, and all the players are ready to support them.
What are some of the mysteries you want to demystify about women and entrepreneurship?
I would say first is to say, like, they have the potential. They have a bigger role. I would say in a household, if a woman is empowered, as you say, the whole household is empowered. And I think it's upon us now to say that they have a potential, they have the skills, they have the ability, and the systems must come in to support them. That is basically what will be demystified.
All right, women have been so much vocal, especially in the country today. We have very young women who are CEOs. They're all over the entrepreneurial field. What do you think about that? Is it creating some sort of competition?
Yeah, first of all, I just want to say Kenya is one of those ecosystems in Africa that is really considered maturing. Once you find that women and young girls are getting into spaces that previously were predominantly somehow, an exclusion for men, then that is a good sign. So in terms of innovation, in terms of entrepreneurship at the grassroots level, we are looking at how can we, sit down and highlight some of the progress that has been made in making the women become competitive. We are looking at skills. We are looking at how the innovation mindset. We are looking at knowledge. We are looking at networks. We are looking at funding opportunities. We are looking at the policy. We are looking at capacity. So it's a lot of people. It's a lot of things that are going to be discussed and going to be highlighted during the year 2019. But most importantly, I think that the ecosystem is really mature.
Yes, focusing on not only the women, EPSAF also serves for youths. What are you up for youths? What is there in store for young people?
Yeah, just to give a quick highlight of why our existence is in the ecosystem is that we are a youth-driven organization that started in 2015. And our model is about accelerating the potentials the young people hold and believing that should we harness their potential, we'll be able to have less of the challenges they are facing. Talk about an employment crisis. And with the understanding that we have the youth bulge crisis, which is affecting not only Kenya but Africa at large, we have modeled program to around innovation, around entrepreneurship. And basically, our focus is how do we send out young people to the communities they come from to innovate around solutions that would serve communities and create opportunities for themselves. So we have also a network around East Africa and a bigger network in Africa. And also we also do a bit of exchange program with the global network, say the European Youth Network, basically to create the opportunities for young people to be able to exchange and revolve around building opportunities for themselves.
I want us not to dwell so much on the young people because this year your theme is in women.
Yeah, sure.
Women have got a lot of potential, and most people say it's untapped potential. Do you think there's so much of untapped potential in terms of the girls and the women that we have today?
I would say that's why we are on it this year, mm-hmm. because based on our last year's mm-hmm. conversation, mm-hmm. we realized like among the disadvantages that we hold in the ecosystem is either people are not able to access the needed technology or the needed resources, say, to do a startup, but also in terms of how do we understand the differences that exist even in terms of gender, and then the fact that the world also is calling upon among women to be able to come out boldly and mm-hmm. be competitive with the counterparts.
Yes, yes.
So what we believe is equally women and men have the same opportunities. Right. And now this year is just to bring out in volume, just to dictate mm-hmm. and say, mm-hmm. well, women in the ecosystem have the potential, they right. have the skills, the resources that is needed is still within the ecosystem. Mm-hmm. How do we harness that, put them on the table, and also put out their voice and mm-hmm. bring in the policies and opportunities that would bring them together?
Great. Are we at par in terms of the level at which entrepreneurial field is growing in terms of women in Africa in relation to Kenyan women?
Pardon, when you say...
How are we really on target? Are we really looking and focusing on something? Are we really aiming?
Yes, and I think, like I said earlier, mm-hmm. the Kenyan ecosystem has been very, very promising, especially in how it looks at women. And for GS, our concept has always been, yes, we have entrepreneurs in urban centers. Mm-hmm. We have entrepreneurs across the world that have so much access to resources and opportunities. A typical entrepreneur in Nairobi mm-hmm. is somebody who has, you know, a walking distance to a hub where they can go and collaborate and, you know, work on projects with different people. But there is this entrepreneur who is called the grassroots entrepreneur. This is somebody from the counties. This is somebody outside Nairobi. So most of the time, you find that these type of entrepreneurs are neglected. Mm-hmm. And that is why we felt like, you know, as a GES, we need to highlight those neglected entrepreneurs. Mm-hmm. And just coming back to your question, I believe that we, as an ecosystem, are doing quite a lot to make sure that the girls actually, you know, are able to compete on the same level as the men entrepreneurs. And if mm-hmm. there are any, you know, gaps, mm-hmm. If there are any opportunities for improvement, then that's the reason why we'll be having GES 2019.
Yes.
To bring success stories to the table. You know, women, amazing definitely. Women in the social impact spaces mm-hmm. who have already had so much success mm-hmm. within their industries, come to this this summit mm-hmm. as panelists, mm-hmm. as mentors, as trainers, as workshop leaders,
great.
And talk to other aspiring mm-hmm. young women so that they can see if so-and-so mm-hmm. you know, was able to become very successful in renewable energy, for example, mm-hmm. it means energy, after all, is not a preserve for men. Mm-hmm. Women also have a space in it.
All right.
If somebody else is, you know, has an amazing social impact startup within health, you know, probably a young entrepreneur who is a woman can be able to see and look up to that, and be able to, you know, find inspiration, mm-hmm. find people to, you know, network with, find people to tap for opportunities.
Gaku, you mentioned something about knowledge and information earlier on. I want to ask these. You're talking about the grassroots. And we're talking about women or the young ladies that are so much into the interiors. How aggressive are you in terms of reaching to those who are so much in the interior, the rural areas?
So currently, it hasn't been you know, an aggressive attempt by the ecosystem. Mm-hmm. That is why GES 2019 will be seeking to highlight mm-hmm. Those gap opportunities
right.
and, you know, bring out the voice mm-hmm. of those grassroots interior mm-hmm. women entrepreneurs and say, you know, tell the ecosystem, you know what? Yes, you're doing an amazing job in Nairobi,
right.
and we acknowledge that. But how about, you know, you go down to Kajiado, mm-hmm. where MSAV was running a project, you know, in digital literacy, along mm-hmm. with digital literacy skills, and be able to create the same impact,
yes.
so that this mm-hmm. entrepreneur, this mm-hmm. woman entrepreneur, this woman leader from the grassroots mm-hmm. is not feeling neglected.
All right. Yeah. We are talking about GES, and probably someone at home is like, what is that? What are they talking about? I'd like you to bring people on board, probably. What is it all about? When is it happening? Where is it taking place?
Yeah, maybe just as I come to your point, I'll also add when you mentioned about aggressiveness and what the organization be doing.
Mm-hmm.
We have a model that we call the DigiLab, which is called the Digital Laboratories. They are young, it's a small kind of a hub at the community level. So when you go to a place like Kajiado, we have a DigiLab in Kajiado, we have a DigiLab in Makueni, we have a DigiLab in Kitui, And our main target are women, and we do 60% women participation in digital literacy training and entrepreneurship. That is how we are focused and looking into women empowerment and entrepreneurship. And now bringing in GES as for the viewer to understand us better, we understand that we have the Global Entrepreneurship Summit that brings together the big players, the World Bank, the UN, everyone, World Economic Forum, everyone together, and they discuss the entrepreneur. With that understanding, we came to understand that the young entrepreneurs are not given an opportunity to speak and then the ecosystem players listen. So it's a contrast of the same. And now what we do, we channel young people from across the country. It is a free to attend for young entrepreneurs. And this time round, we are theming it around women entrepreneurs. And then the concept is about, we will be doing a workshop, a three-day workshop for young entrepreneurs, female entrepreneurs, this time around. And we have a bias because in women in tech, because again, we also looking into how do we encroach the systems that have been predominantly led by men in the ecosystem. So we, it's an annual event. It has a different theme. This time round, it's around women in social entrepreneurship. And we have a collaboration with an organization called the Women's World Wide Web. It is an organization, it's a global organization. It's a global champion for women in tech and entrepreneurship. They are actually sponsoring most of our activities, including the workshop. And basically, that is what we do. We channel the young people in the ecosystem by bringing in players who are ready to support, who are ready to understand what are we doing. And this time round, it will be in Kenyatta University. This is where that's where we did last year. That is where we'll be doing the workshop, and the summit will be on 19th of September.
Great. And that's amazing. Probably we hope to be there also.
Yes, sure.
To, so as we can see what women have to offer for us. I want us to come on, to come together and look at the government sustainable development agendas, the nine of them. Do you think women are really included in all this?
The government?
In terms of inclusivity?
I think yes. Yes. And I want to, you know, in my, in an individual capacity, of course, appreciate, you know, the, you know, the work government is doing and different development partners and different organizations, especially in, you know, uplifting the place of women in some of these development development agendas. I just want to, you know, mention, you know, a lot of, you know, ongoing, you know, progresses in the, within the Big Four agenda, for example. We know, and when you come to the GES 2019, you'll meet an amazing panelist of women, 100% women, who are, you know, doing amazing work.
100% women.
Within the four, the Big Four agenda.
All right.
For example, one of the panelists probably could be, you know, somebody from you know, renewable energy, which is supporting manufacturing in a huge way. We have people who are doing a lot in education, especially using technology tools to support how, you know, students in the rural areas access information and these skills. And I think just looking at that, I think there has been a lot of progress.
Let's probably, there's probably a young lady at home who is watching, and she's just like, I wanted to begin this company, but then I'm apparently facing too much of challenges. What would you advise someone who is beginning a company?
I would say, when you say actually starting a company, sometimes it's so, it sounds so huge. But what I believe and what our model propagates, and that is the, even the conversation we always have when we are doing the summits or any other convening that we do here in town, it's mainly to tell the young people that it starts with an idea. And that is why in our training and our curriculum, we talk a lot about ideation, the ideation process, how you do your ideation to understand what to offer as a solution, because what we say, a startup or what people call a company.